blessed day to everyone who may be viewing this, whatever time you may be. I greet you in the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I just want to thank you for tuning in, for subscribing, and for watching. God bless you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And I give all the glory only to God, because He deserves all the glory. Today, the word of the Lord, or the blessing to us, encouragement, comes from the word of the Lord in the book of Psalms, chapter 1. It's a psalm of David. Psalm chapter 1 has 6 verses. And 6 is the number of man. I remember in Genesis that God created man on the 6th day. So 6th symbolizes the number for man. And in this blessed psalm of Psalm chapter 1, 6 verses, 3 verses deals with the blessed man, and 3 verses deals with the ungodly man. So if I should use a title today, it would be The Blessed Man Versus the Ungodly Man. And it begins by saying, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in this law doth he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever doeth shall prosper. That's a good part. But now we get to the ungodly man. It says, the ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. So from verse 1 we see, if we want to talk about someone being blessed, these are some unique things that must be done in order for you to be blessed. It says, blessed is the man, first of all, that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. In order for you to be a blessed man, you cannot walk in the counsel of the ungodly, in the advice of the ungodly. Because light and darkness cannot mix. So it's not feasible or possible for darkness and light to mix. Because when darkness exists and light comes, the moment light comes, darkness disappears. So the blessed man, in order to be considered blessed, first thing, you must not walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Number 2, you cannot stand in the way of sinners. You cannot stand in the way of sinners. It says standeth. That means it's a continuous thing. We are continue to stand in the way of sinners. Number 3, you should not sit in the seat of the scornful. As a believer, a godly man, you cannot mix with the ungodly or seek their counsel. Number 2, you cannot stand in the way of sinners. And number 3, you cannot sit in the seat of the scornful. Being a blessed man, you have to move away from being scornful, or even in the seat of the scornful. Number 4, your delight must be in the law of the Lord. Your delight must be in the law of the Lord. The law of the Lord here refers to the Torah, which is the first 5 books of the Bible. If you look into the Hebrew, it's the law of the Lord, and you must delight yourself in it. That means you want to read it, you want to get acquainted with it, you want to study it, so that every moment of the day or in times of your life, then those laws, those books of the Bible will become a part of your being. Number 5 now says that, and in this law the same law that you must delight in, you must meditate on it day and night. You read the word, you study the word, and you meditate on it day and night. You keep bringing it back to your memory, and you do that day and night. And as a result of doing those things, then here comes the blessed part. He says, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. So the first thing, you shall be like a tree. And not just any tree, but a tree that is planted by the rivers of water. So that means there will be continuous sustenance for this tree. And it is so unique then, because if this tree is planted by the rivers of water, it means then that there will be an abundance of moisture, abundance of nutrients, abundance of provision where water is concerned. That means this tree will never lack water. And as a result, he shall bring forth fruit in his season, in your season. I'm declaring over your life, because you have followed all that God has said, because you have been obedient to what God says. You did not walk in the counsel of the ungodly. You did not stand in the way of sinner. You did not sit in the seat of the scornful. But you delighted yourself and continued to delight yourself in the law of the Lord and meditate on it day and night. I am declaring that you shall be like a tree that is planted by the rivers of water. And you shall bring forth your fruit in your season. It goes further to say that his leaf shall not wither, nor shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. So even though you're in a place where there's a lot of water being drawn by the roots, the leaf shall never wither, my God. And whatsoever you do shall prosper. That's the promises that were made regarding the blessed man. So you will not, your leaves will not wither. That means there will be an evergreen leaves where you are concerned. And the other side now, which is the godly man, we have just looked at the blessed man. The ungodly man is not so. It begins in verse 4. It says it's not so. But he is like the chaff which the winds drive it away. You're just like something, a dry leaf, as we experience fall. That leaf goes anywhere that the wind takes it. And that's the first thing of the ungodly man. You shall be tossed to and fro by the winds of life, and you shall be driven away as a chaff. And the ungodly man, number 2, shall not stand in the judgment. Wow. Nor sinners, which are ungodly as well, in the congregation of the righteous. So the righteous and the ungodly man will never mix. On that day, we may be mixing now, but you shall not stand in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous. My God, that's an additional one to the blessed man know. To know that the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous. And then the final part now says, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. So the blessed man will be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. You have a choice today. What do you want to do? To be? Do you want to be like a tree which is planted by the rivers of water? Or do you want to be like the ungodly person that shall perish? I pray for you now in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for every person watching this now. And I give them, God, the opportunity for you now, Lord, for them to hear your voice. So that when you call unto them, God, they will receive you. They will not be like the ungodly, but they will be righteous. by accepting you as your Lord and Savior, confessing their sins to you, knowing that you died on the cross to pay the sin debt. May they consider to be a blessed man this morning. May they consider to stay away from the ungodly, or to not be like the ungodly, but live a godly life, because the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous. God bless you.